Good morning, students. Yesterday, I discussed the meaning of capital market, and then I discussed the four functions of capital market. Today, I am going to discuss the remaining four functions of capital market. Now, before going to start today, once more I want to remind you, whenever you are going to write the functions of capital market, what you are supposed to do, first you have to write the subheading. After writing the subheading, you must underline them. And after underlining them, you explain those subheadings in your own language. Okay? And if you explain it on your own language, definitely you are going to score a very good marks. So today, I am going to discuss the remaining four functions of capital market. First function, ready market. Now, when I am going to explain you about the ready market, what do you mean by market? All of you are knowing what is a market? Market is a place where basically buying and selling of some commodities are taken place. That is what is called market. Now, what do you mean by ready? Let me tell you what do you mean by ready. When it's been completely ready for the purpose of buying and selling, then it is called ready. Like I want to give an example. If you have seen a market near to your house, what you have noticed? Early morning you must have been noticed the vendors, means those who are going to sell the goods, early morning they come to the market. They arrange their things on a particular place. And then they get ready for the customers to come to the market. Same thing happening in the capital market also. What you are noticing in the capital market? In the capital market, that capital market is also ready always to sell the securities to the investors. In the capital market is basically a link between who save money and who need money. So capital market, what kind of people go? The people, those who are interested to save money, they also go to the capital market. And the persons, those who need to save money, they also go to the capital market. So which kind of people are going to the capital market? Those who wants to save money and those who need money. Like when who are going to the market? There is two types of people are going to the market. One, those who are ready to sell the commodities, and another, those who are ready to buy the commodities. So every market you must have been noticed two kinds of people are going. One are called seller, the other are called buyer. So in the capital market also two types of persons are going to the capital market. Who all are they? One, those who wants to save money and those who needs money. Like if I want to save my money, I go to the capital market to buy different kinds of shares or some securities, which will provide me in my future some more benefit. And who are the buyer? Buyers are those, basically the business organization, who wants to increase their capital. They go there for what purpose? Because they need to increase their fund. So these two types, that is what is called the ready market. Now next one is coming, transfer of funds. You know the meaning of transfer. When something is going from one hand to another, that is what is basically called the transfer of transfer. Now here I am talking about transfer of funds. What do you mean by transfer of funds? Transfer of funds means when the money is moving from one financial account to the other account, that is what is called transfer of funds. Like, you know, sometimes you go to the bank and what you do? We do the RTGS transfer. What do you mean by the RTGS transfer? Like today, the money is in my account. Tomorrow, I transfer that particular money to one of my relatives' accounts. So what is happening here? Here, the fund is being transformed from one person to another. So in the capital market, what is happening there? Money is moving from one financial account to another. So today the money is with me, tomorrow it can go to other. That means when today I bought the share is with me. Tomorrow when I sell the share to someone else, that particular person will be the shareholder. So as the transfer of fund is being taken place. Next point is coming, balance between demand and supply. Remember this is very important words. Demand and supply. What do you mean by the demand? Again, I'm coming to a practical day-to-day life. If you go to the market, to your nearby place, what you have noticed, the supply of vegetables are more and the buyer are less, what you have been noticed? You have been noticed the cost of vegetables are very less. And who is the loser? The farmer. The seller who come to the market to sell the vegetable, they are the loser. Why they are the loser? Because last time when they come to the market, they thought the supply of the commodities was less last day. And today what happened? Suddenly the supply is more and the demand is less because of the rain, because of the COVID-19. Might be the customers, those who are interested to buy the goods from the market, less number of persons must have gone to the market. When less number of persons gone to the market, what is happening there? The demand will be less. And what is more? Supply will be more. Because the buyers are less in numbers and supply is more. When buyers are less in number and supply is more, that particular business is going to lose their money. Similarly, in capital market, what they basically do, they always keep the balance between the demand and the supply. Whenever you are going to learn the function of marketing, one of the most important function of marketing to keep the demand and supply in equilibrium state. That means the demand and supply has an equality. So here also same thing happening in the capital market. They always keep the balance between the demand and the supply. When there is the balance between the demand and the supply of capital, what is going to happen? Then the price will neither increase too much nor it will go down too much. Okay? Next point is coming, stability. This stability is related with the point demand and balance between the demand and supply. If there is the balance between the demand and supply is equal or it is in equilibrium state, what you will notice? You will notice the stability in the capital market. Okay, so the values of the securities will be stable. Neither it will increase too much nor it will decrease too much. Like in your house, you are keeping a stabilizer. What the stabilizer do? Now when there is low power supply also there, or high power supply also there, what the stabilizer basically do? The stabilizer stable the flow of the current. Because if the flow of the current is too much, what is going to happen? The equipments what you are keeping in your house, that is going to spoil. On the other hand, if the supply of the electricity is less, there also the equipments are going to be spoiled. So what the stabilizer is doing? He is keeping the stability in the supply of the electricity. Similarly, by balancing the demand and supply, the capital market keep the stability of values of the security. Whatever value is there in the security, they always keep a stability. Neither they allow them to increase too much or it go down too much. I hope you understood the remaining four functions of capital market. And I told you, in your syllabus, from the capital market, only two things you are supposed to learn for the board examination. Number one, meaning of capital market. And the number two, function of capital market. So I hope it is clear to you. Thank you.